The song came about where I just heard the beat, and that it just moved me like in my soul. So I knew I wanted to do something real thought-provoking on that beat, and what better to do than do something that hasn't been done by unsigned artists, period, or you know, for a long, long time. So I decided to go that route and really put my all into it. So it took a lot of like researching and reading and all of that stuff to make sure I put that message out, you know, efficiently. So, you know, it came out well, and then, you know, I was proud of it. It's one of my best joints I've ever written. They back me in the corner, so I'm pushing back. They still judging for hoodies and wearing crooked caps. They follow us in them stores, what the fuck you looking at? But now I'm aggressive, right? It's funny, look at that. Basically, that's just how it ends up being set up, you know, like they provoke us to, you know, react. And when they get us to react, they do the see, I told you they were animals, and I told you they were, you know, angry people, and they're monkeys, whatever the case may be. But you've been following me around this store for the past 15 minutes. Yes, I'm aggravated, and yes, I'm angry. You know, so it's some people that can deal with it and some people that can't, but we still shouldn't be, you know, criminalized for it. Politicians with propositions, them crooked cats. That's why we gotta progress without looking back. We need an escape. Mines, yeah, look at rap. I bury my pain in these bars, homie. Hooks and tracks. They tried to bury us behind bars. They took us back. Criminalizing my people. Check the books, it's facts. But it's on war and drugs, right? What the fuck is that? Now that's just, you know, when, you know, I read a book called, Kill 'Em Before They Grow, and I also read the new Jim Crow. So that was really, you know, talking about the war on drugs, you know, propaganda that went on in, you know, the 80s or whatever the case may be, whenever, you know, the crack epidemic went up. And what ended up happening was, you know, they stopped funding, you know, drug prevention, and, you know, gave more money to, you know, put them into like the law enforcement so they can lock these people up. But, you know, most of these people needed help. But the thing was, they wanted to, you know, keep the black population down. So like I said, politicians were propositions, them crooked cats. They got their own propositions and their own agendas, and unfortunately, we're not a part of that. So that was addressing that part.
Fuck jail cells, we need education, teachers, even black leaders, fuck probation. When they killed X and Martin, they killed our spirit. So many lost souls in the hood, you can fucking feel it. They blame us for being lost, fuck the critics. It's on us to build us, fuck statistics.
That's basically, you know, it's saying, you know, like, you know, when they killed X and they killed, you know, they killed Martin, you know, a lot of people were disheartened. And, you know, if you look at, you know, what it was then, what it is now, we're not fighters anymore. And that's what I mean by they killed our spirit, our fighting spirit. They gave us that fighting spirit. What they did was they took it from us. Unfortunately, they shouldn't have, but, you know, that's what ended up happening. And fuck jail cells, we need educations, teachers, even black leaders, fuck probation. You know what I'm saying? They lock us up more than they give us the education that we need. And we don't need, you know, to be educated on these things that have nothing to do with us. And Kill 'Em Before They Grow, it basically talks about how they kill us, you know, early in the education system. So we need to be educated on, you know, our history, you know, instill that black pride from jump. But, you know, we're not in the history books. We get 1 month out of the year. And, you know, we're not educated on our culture. Therefore, we don't take our own culture serious. So that was addressing that.
It's because numbers lying. You damn sure know people do. Look in their eyes, empty souls is what I'm peeping through. I shed a tear for my people, the cries I'm weeping through. The blood of slaves in my veins, and it's seeping through. It's time to wake up, brother, so fuck the sleeping dude. Because time is lost and death, it'll creep on you. Because these are the words of God in the vessel he's speaking through. I breathe life into these lyrics. What I speak is true.
That's just me talking about, you know, my passion for the subject, you know, just, you know, feeling that verse, you know. I gave you so much information in there, and, you know, now you're getting kind of the back end of the information and what, you know, the lyrics actually meant. So, you know, that's just me saying, you know, the blood of slaves in my veins, you know, those are my ancestors, so I'm sleeping through. These are the words of God, I'm the vessel he's speaking through. You know, I just use myself as an instrument to, you know, put God's word out there, you know, give people something, you know, else to listen to besides, you know, the boom bap or whatever else I do, you know what I mean? So that's just me talking about my passion for the subject and my passion for my culture and my people. So, you know, that's what that was.